Thank you. I call George Foulkes, after which we'll come to wind-up speeches.
Presiding Officer, you and others may be aware that earlier this year I stood, probably unwisely and certainly unsuccessfully, for the post of Rector of Edinburgh University. But it did enable me to hear the views of many hundreds of students, which I'm going to try and reflect today. Edinburgh is a renowned educational, world-renowned educational institution, hugely impressive record of research, particularly in the growth industries of bioscience, informatics, regenerative medicine, which is going to power Scotland's economy in the future. They've got 26,000 students at Edinburgh from 120 countries around the world, but several thousand Scottish students who rely not just on the funding of the university, but on their funding on the SNP government. And we've heard from Murdo, Fraser and Pauline McNeill about the SNP's broken promises to dump student debt. And we've also heard the tired rebuttal from Fiona Hislop yet again that student debt is allegedly falling. Presiding Officer, they may have convinced themselves of that fact. They may even have convinced a number of wet-behind-the-ear journalists of that. But all the students that I spoke to during that rectorial campaign are not convinced of that at all. They feel totally abandoned by the SNP. 700 students on one Facebook petition set up by the current president of the SRC at Edinburgh University, students signed up to this statement. Fiona Hislop fails to understand that many students are struggling as much as anyone else. Our families are suffering from the credit crunch. The job market is drying up. If the SNP allow poorer students to be priced out of education, they will be allowing a short-term recession to condemn a generation. And now, the Cabinet Secretary says, rightly, that their debt to the government is falling. Interest-free debt, or as Murdo pointed out, thanks to the Labour government at Westminster. But their debt to Topshop, to Barclaycard, to Visa, with high interest rates, that debt is going up. And it's a complete travesty when the SNP government have the power they need to do something about it. All they lack is the will to do something about it. They could extend the loan thresholds to match those in England and Wales, as has already been said, but they won't. They could agree a guaranteed minimum income for students of £7,000, as Karen Whitfield argued eloquently just a few moments ago, but they won't. They could provide more money for campus student hardship funds, but they won't. And here in Edinburgh, there are nearly 100,000 part- or full-time students critical to the economic future of our country. And what they need from this government is support, not an insult from the Education Minister, to grow up and stop complaining. That really was patronising and insulting. The student community, Mr. Presiding Officer, feels totally let down by the SNP and by the Education Secretary personally. Whatever you may think about top-up fees, right or wrong, at least the community, the student community, knew what they were up against. They knew the rules of engagement and the nature of the debate. The SNP's higher education policy and the complete lack of principle that forms its shaky foundations, it's an enigma and anathema to the student community. Presiding Officer, what students want is a guaranteed minimum income so that they can keep commercial debts low and part-time hours down. What they are getting from this government is a raft of broken promises, arrogance and ignorance.